So, in this video, we are demonstrate the process of converting octal numbers to decimal. So, we can convert an octal number to decimal by, if it is a integral part, we can convert by multiplying the digits with the powers of 8. Here you can see that an example is given, 752, which is an octal number, right? So 752 to the base 8. So like in the case of binary to decimal, we are counting the powers from the right side. So it is 3 digits are there, 0, 1, 2. Right. So we can write it as 7 into 8 raised to 2 plus 5 into 8 raised to 1 plus 2 into 8 raised to 0. So it is 7 into 8 raised to 2, it is 64. 7 into 64 plus 5 into 8 plus 2 into 1, because 8 raised to 0, it is 1. So we will be getting it as 448 plus 40 plus 2 equal to 490. So 752 to the base 8 is the octal number, and equivalent decimal is 490 to the base 10. Okay. Here we can see how we can convert a fractional part of octal number to decimal, right? We can convert a fractional part of an octal number to decimal by multiplying the digits with the negative powers of 8. So in the given example, 0.125 to the base 8. So you can see that we can write it as 1 into 8 raised to minus 1 plus 2 into 8 raised to minus 2 plus 5 into 8 raised to minus 3, which can be written as 8 raised to minus 1 can be written as 1 by 8 plus 2 by 64 and 5 by 512. So you can see the calculations. So it is better to use a calculator in this side, right? So we will be getting the answer as 0.1661 to the base 10 is the equivalent octal. Okay. So here is our first question based on the conversion of octal to decimal. So it is 275.512 to the base 8. 275.512 is the octal number. So we want to find the corresponding decimal part. So we are separating the integral part. Integral part, you can see that it is 275, and fractional part is 0.512. So look into the integral part. So as there are 3 digits, so the power starting from 3 to, so 3 digits, so the power starts from 210, right? That is, when we expand, 2 into 8 raised to 2 plus 7 into 8 raised to 1 plus 5 into 8 raised to 0, right? That is 2 into 64 plus 7 into 8, it is 56, plus 5 into 1. So that is 128 plus 56 plus 5. So we will be getting the answer as 189 to the base 10, which is the equivalent decimal of the integral part. Now we look into the fractional part. 0.512 is the fractional part. So 0.512, So multiplying with the negative powers of 8, 5 into 8 raised to minus 1 plus 1 into 8 raised to minus 2 plus 2 into 8 raised to minus 3. So we can write it as 5 by 8 plus 1 by 64 plus 2 by 512. See the calculations here, and we will be getting the result as 06445 is the equivalent decimal fractional part. And the final result by combining the integral part and fractional part, it is 189.6445 to the base 10. That is the final result. So here is another question. This is 300.72 is the octal number. So integral part is 300, fractional part is 0.72. So the integral part, as there are 3 digits, so 3 into 8 raised to 2 plus 0 into 8 raised to 1 plus 0 into 8 raised to 0. So it will be 3 into 64, it is 192. Remaining terms will become 0. So the 300 is the octal and 192 is the corresponding decimal. Right. Now look into the fractional part, 0.72. So which can be written as 7 into 8 raised to minus 1 plus 2 into 8 raised to minus 2, which can be written as 7 by 8 plus 2 by 64, which is equal to 0.90625. So when we combine the result, we can see that 300.72 to the base 8 is equal to 192.90625 is the resultant decimal number. Okay.